Obama's against the small businessman.
Mitt Romney strapped children to the roof of his car.
Show us the birth certificate.
Romney would tax only the homeless.
Barack Obama's economic plan will cost 2 million jobs.
That can't all be true.
It's all lies. What's even the point of voting?
Yeah, why bother?
You guys!
People in other countries are literally dying to get a right to vote. Democracy is a beautiful thing. Yeah, there's a lot of money corrupting politics in the US, but how is it going to get any better if we don't educate ourselves on the issues and vote for the candidate who represents us? So don't listen to the experts on TV. We can be our own experts. So who's with me? It's good for democracy.
In terms of taxes, Obama supports higher tax rates for the rich and tax cuts for the middle class. At the beginning of his presidency, he passed tax cuts for 95% of all working class families and signed 18 tax cuts for small businesses. Following the economic crisis of 2008, Obama passed the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act. This is also known as the economic stimulus of 2009. Some critics think it should have had a bigger impact, but it did have some effect. He increased the number of people employed by 1 million to 2 million. However, the cost of the economic stimulus itself was $819 billion. In terms of federal spending, Obama wants to end taxpayer subsidies to oil companies and use the money saved to promote clean energy such as solar energy and wind energy.
Mitt Romney's economic background comes from his work at Bain Capital and also from his time as the Massachusetts governor. As the CEO of Bain, Romney was extremely successful, and the company prospered. However, Bain has also been tied to such actions as bankrupting companies acquired, causing hundreds of lost jobs, as well as outsourcing jobs overseas. On the other hand, Romney was fairly successful as the governor of Massachusetts. He slowed and then reversed the decline of jobs in Massachusetts. According to his own website, Romney wants to reduce taxes for pretty much everyone across the board, from companies to individuals. Romney is very supportive of deregulation and wants to remove regulations which might slow or hinder business. Romney is not an environmentalist. Keeping businesses and the economy strong takes priority over protecting the environment for him. Romney also supports cutting down on government spending. Many of the spending cuts he proposes would come from doing away with some of the programs that Obama instituted, as well as funding for the arts and humanities, and also by stopping funding for programs he is ideologically opposed to, like Planned Parenthood. He would make no cuts to the military budget, though. In fact, he would increase it.
Obama's record shows that he passed the Affordable Care Act, which covers patients regardless of pre-existing conditions or gender, in March 2010. He also believes in the individual mandate. If you can afford health care, you must buy it. If you, like 250 million other Americans, already have health care, you will keep it. Obama's health care plan was modeled after Romney's Massachusetts one. Both plans require that everyone buys health insurance, mandate that businesses offer health care to employees, include subsidies for people who can't afford health insurance, and include penalties on those who can afford insurance but don't buy coverage. In his platform, however, in a USA Today op-ed written by Romney, he states that his first act as president would be working towards getting rid of Obamacare. He states Obamacare would increase spending, increase federal involvement in health care, and hurt the United States economy. It includes too high taxes and too much federal control over people's lives. Instead of Obamacare, he writes that the states should be empowered to make their own health care decisions.
Barack Obama was against gay marriage in 2008. As president last year, Obama repealed the Don't Ask, Don't Tell law, which stopped gay Americans and lesbians from serving openly in the military. This summer, Obama has announced that he has decided to support gay marriage some time ago, but he had been waiting for the most appropriate time to announce it.
When running against Ted Kennedy for Senator of Massachusetts in 1994, Romney supported gay rights, saying that the gay community needed a voice in the Republican Party and that he would be that voice. However, in 2002, when running for governor of Massachusetts, he changed his views. He believes that marriage should only be between man and woman.
but he thinks the decision about whether or not gay marriage should be legal should be made by the individual states.
Obama is pro-choice and has shown consistent support for women to have full control over their reproductive rights. He passed the Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act, also known as Obamacare. Women usually pay more for health care, but under that act will now pay the same rates as men. Birth control will also be fully covered in many insurance plans. He also doesn't support required parental notification, in which teens must notify their parents if they want to have an abortion.
Mitt Romney was once pro-choice but is now strongly pro-life. Issues2000.org reports that in 2002, Romney released statements about being in favor of giving women the choice of having an abortion to the Lowell Sun newspaper. In 2005, he vetoed a contraception bill that allows contraceptives without prescription. In 2012, he stated an interest in reversing Roe v. Wade. During his campaign for the 2012 presidential election, Romney released an ad in Iowa that made it seem as though he was always pro-life, which is misleading.
Obama initiated the Race to the Top program. Under this program, states will receive federal money for raising school and teaching standards. The main goal of this program is to help students graduate and be ready for college, and to have the necessary skills to outcompete workers in other parts of the world. During his presidency, Obama was able to keep his promises in certain areas. According to PolitiFact.com, he increased research opportunities for college students and protected student borrowers from predatory lending, taxes on loans, and others. However, he didn't have much luck in other areas. He failed to get Congress to increase funding for the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act and to fund the College Credit Initiative. No funding was for the encouragement of AP classes and other college readiness programs were made.
According to the New York Times, Mitt Romney supports a voucher policy which allows students in grades K-12 to use $25 billion of federal money in order to attend any school, public, private, charter, or online. U.S. News and World Report says that Romney's education plan, known as A Chance for Every Child, is supposed to help young Americans complete higher education by focusing less on four-year college degrees and more on two-year college degrees, occupational certificates, and apprenticeships, so that students are guaranteed jobs after they finish school and therefore be able to pay back their loans. Romney would also like to cut Pell Grants.
Everything that we researched here about Obama and Romney, everything was new to me because it was never spoken about in my school.
Before, I researched Obama and his gay rights and his stance, I didn't know anything about the Don't Ask, Don't Tell law. I didn't even know it was repealed last year. I didn't even know what it was because I wasn't taught these things in school. And, we should learn this because, once we get older and be able to vote and we're able to go into the world, we're not going to know what to vote for.
Romney's education platform, it made me also want to vote, but I still don't know for who. Because it made me realize how much presidents can do for young people and how much they're not doing. For example, in his education platform, he wants to cut Pell Grants and make it harder for poor kids to get Pell Grants, which makes no sense to me because it's already hard for us to go to school, so you want to make it harder.
I wouldn't have actually thought about voting because it didn't really matter to me. My mom didn't vote, so I never really thought of it. But then when I started researching the candidates and their platforms and stuff, some of the stuff that I learned about, how polar opposite they are about what they want for the country, it really made me want to vote because I didn't want some of the platforms to go through for some of the candidates because I started really caring about what the heck's going to happen with the country.